Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. We are so happy to finally be back again after a long pandemic interlude. Tonight you'll hear plenty of music, some old, some new, some you know, and some you might not. We hope you'll enjoy the music Ken's put together for you. Thank you all for helping to support the Mojave Valley Food Pantry with your donations tonight. We really appreciate it so very much. Now, let's get this party started with the sweet sounds of love. Have you ever been so in love that you could fly to the moon?
Thank you, everybody, for coming. I really appreciate you being here. And I'm heard okay. Okay. I'm going to play some love songs tonight, and there's going to be some mingled in some things to it. And one of the songs that I just played right now, would you know, that was actually played during the Super Bowl commercial? It was played during a Super Bowl commercial. Frank Sinatra originally sang that, and I never thought I'd see it in this day and era, especially in the Super Bowl, during the Super Bowl. Did you watch the Super Bowl? Yeah. Did you have to see the halftime show? This isn't going to be anything like that. Boy, oh boy. So tonight, I'm going to start with a song that I used to play for my folks when I was a little boy. I'd come home from school, I'd wait for my folks to get home, and then we'd have dinner, and they'd sit in the couch, and I'd start playing the organ. And if I could put them to sleep, I knew I did a good job. So as the sun went down and I played the organ, I watched my parents go to sleep to this song.
Thank you.
asleep now. I think they are. They would usually be right after the very first song. I guess they work pretty hard. The next song reminds me of a close friend. I won't name her. She's here. And I think of her every time I play this song. And it occurred to me that it fits everybody's life. It shows up someplace in everybody's life. It's called Only You. I had the wrong music up there. Half of the songs I'm playing tonight are by heart. The other half I put together for the program. That was put together for the program. Doggone it. All right, I'll get back on track though. Okay. The next song I'm going to play, I hope I can, is the title of it means my beloved in Italian. Does anybody know what that might be? What's the name of this song? My Beloved is what the title means. A tip is my daughter's name is the first word in this title. Can't think of it? Cara. Cara Mia. Cara Mia. Here it comes. This is for my daughter. Through and we've picked songs over several different eras. This one goes back to the 60s and the 70s. There are a couple of my old favorites. So let's just get started with those. Oh, name, because, and Go Away, Little Girl.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm going to play a newer song now. It's the name of it's Keeper of the Stars, and it's a ballad that was released back in the 90s. My kids know it. My kids are in their 40s now, so it was big for them in the 90s, I guess. And it's a beautiful song. It's about a guy who's so much in love with his girl that he believes there's somebody else had a hand in it. Something happened to have him land with her. So he tips his hat to the Keeper of the Stars. Have you heard that before? Anybody? I never had. It was new to me. So I talked about my folks a lot, and back in the days when I was learning how to play the organ, I loved putting them to sleep, and I didn't like playing in bands that much. I didn't get to be the show, I guess. I don't know. I didn't like it, and so one day at dinner time, my dad asked me if I wanted to go down to the Wharf restaurant and have dinner, maybe meet the organist. I said, sure. This is back in the day when they had organs and pianos at the dinner houses. The Wharf was down on the Seattle waterfront. We packed up everybody. We headed down to the waterfront. We had dinner. The organist came over. Jimmy Secor was his name. He talked with me a little bit, and He said that he'd seen me at some Wurlitzer concerts and Hammond organ concerts that I had played at when I was real little. And so it was really nice meeting him, and I went home that night, and the next day I got back. My dad said, "Do you want to go down to the wharf again tonight?" I said, "Really? Why?" And he goes, "Just to talk to Jimmy Secor. He wants to talk to you." So I went down there, had dinner, and lo and behold, I was 14 years old. He asked me to play in when he was gone. So I get to fill in for Jimmy, played a couple days a week initially, and played for about a year, I think. Then girls got into my life, and I wanted to go a different direction. But these are the songs that I played way back then. Hope I remember them. Big Band Era. Moonlight Serenade, Deep Purple, I Saw You Last Night and Got That Old Feeling. That's all. Thank you. What I found out playing in a dinner house is that nobody listened. There's a good to bad to that, you know. But it took me a few times before I realized nobody heard that. I still love doing it, though. It's lots of fun for me. Okay, the next medley that I'm going to play, it's an old country western medley. Again, I think some people, when I play this song all the time, and Help Me Make It Through the Night by Kris Kristofferson. It's You're Always on My Mind, recorded by people like Brenda Lee and Elvis Presley, but we all know it from Willie Nelson. I Believe in You, well-known Don Williams song.
Thank you.
Thank you. I was worried to death I'd forget about what to play next, you know, so you can't tell it on the look on my face, but it's there. My next song, the director, that's her back there, and my producer, and my wife, she was against this song. We had quite a little argument about it. Back and forth, back and forth. She wants it, I didn't want it. And finally I just said, you have to stand by me on this one. She says, okay. That's the name of the song, Stand By Me.
It was a discussion.
I started the wrong song. Was worth it, wasn't it? That was worth it. I like that song. Makes me really glad I know how to play. When I get up into that, I just love it. Just sounds so good. But this next one reminds me of how I was kind of left out over the years because I never played in a band. And those guys now, when I watch the guys playing a band, like Ray Gunn, you can see him playing every Sunday, and he's a member of our church. And Ray came and played with me one time, and it was a lot easier. He did all the work. All I did was play, you know. So I didn't learn a lot by not playing with other people. I was always a concert organist, going around from one place to another. So this song is just a fun song for me to play. And it's called Sea of Love. And I love it. But this makes some other sounds. It's a little lighter touch, and I have it at my house. Oh, yeah, I'm supposed to tell you I'm playing. Unchained Melody. Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow? Sleepwalk. Piano Man. And Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Thank you.
His way back home to the organ, I'll tell you that this next song is another one he had to fight for to keep in tonight's A-list. But as it turns out, I am glad he did. This is a love song in an achy breaky heart kind of way. It's by Roy Orbison. So Ken's gonna play Crying.
Yeah, it was the song I started, the other one, and then I started the wrong song. That was this one. Thank you.
John wanted to play that.
Okay, honey. I told her I was going to take a vote whether it should have been in there, but I guess we won't make sides so much with that. And so, well, moving on very quickly. The Spanish version, When the Sun Heats Up, is the name of this song. The Spanish version means the sun heats up. What is that in Spanish, Kath?
Cuando calienta el sol.
Just beautiful and simple.
In English, it's called Love Me With All of Your Heart. Did you throw that one by accident?
Just bear with me. Right there. Now, the part I wanted to talk about the most was my first love, my very first love. And I'll bet you many of the guys here anyway would say that was their first love too. That's me working on that car right there, because that was my 1962 Chevy Supersport. I had Learjet 8-track tape deck, 4 Pioneer speakers, and headsets at each sitting position. I put 50,000 miles on that car and never left the community.
In 1 year.
I lived in it. It made me. So this is back in the days where your car made you. So I started collecting them. All my old cars, every car I ever had, I try to find. I can't find all of them, but find some of them. This song is called Spirit of America. Spirit of America was, if you remember, set the land speed record. Kathy, you want to tell about that?
Yeah. This song was by the Beach Boys, and it's the story of Craig Breedlove, who in 1963, on August 5th, broke the land speed record at the Bonneville Salt Flats in Utah. And the name of his car was Spirit of America. So
the Beach Boys
sang about it.
played a very dangerous game.
It's That's one of
part
the
part
lines.
Of the words. I just want to talk about my car some more. Right here, I have to stop and thank a few people. Those people over there, Frank, is he still here?
Frank just had to leave.
And
but
Janet?
You can thank him anyway.
Janet still here?
I want to
thank
Janet's
Janet.
Here.
Thank you, Janet, for helping out. And of course, my director and my producer, she's going to have to go home and work some more. And Pastor, I want to thank you for giving me this venue. And then really the most part is the most important is I thank God. I thank God for this venue. I thank God I came here to this church. And I've made so many great friends. It's such a great place to be. I thank God. What am I going to do now? These are typical songs for me to end with. They are I Will Always Love You and Time to Say Goodbye. How many know that one? Yeah, you do. It's coming. Thank you all for coming. I appreciate you listening to me. We'll do it again sometime. Okay? Thank you.